Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another area between curves problem. And in this one we've been given the two curves, f of x equals 12x minus 3x squared, and g of x equals 6x minus 24. And we've been asked to find the area between those curves on the range x equals 1 to x equals 7. So let's go ahead first and take a look at the graphs of these two functions. We have the purple graph here, which represents f of x. So let's go ahead and indicate this one here is f of x. And then we have the orange graph, which represents g of x, right? This is g of x. And if you have access to a graphing calculator, you can go ahead and graph these on that. Otherwise, these two functions are pretty simple to sketch the graphs of without the calculator if you need to do that. So either way, we've got f of x and g of x, and we've been asked to find the area on the range 1 to 7. So this is x equals 1 right here, and x equals 7 is right here through g of x that I wrote. All right, so we need to find the area between the curves, between these two lines here. So you can tell that the graphs, these two functions, cross each other. So g of x is above f of x from 4 to 7. From 1 to 4, though, f of x is above g of x. They cross each other at 4, right here in the center. So what we need to do is go ahead and confirm that the intersection is in fact at 4. It looks like it is based on the graphs, but if you couldn't graph these visually, you would want to find out where they intersected anyway. And the way that we would do that is just by setting them equal to each other. So we'll say 12x minus 3x squared equal to 6x minus 24. And if we move everything to the same side, we'll move everything to the right side, we'll get 3x squared plus 6x minus 12x minus 24, and when we simplify, we'll get 3x squared minus 6x minus 24. If we divide by 3, we'll get x squared minus 2x minus 8, and then you can factor this to get x minus 4 times x plus 2. So you know that the graphs cross each other. X has to be equal to 4 and negative 2. So that's where the graphs intersect. Luckily for us, we only have to concern ourselves with one point because negative 2 here is outside our range. Remember that we only care about the range 1 to 7, and negative 2 is outside that range, so we can go ahead and ignore it. 4 is the only intersection point we care about, and we've confirmed that in fact our intersection point is at 4. As we saw on the graph right here. So what that means for us is that we need to go ahead and write our integral. First, we need an integral from 1 to 4. So the left-hand endpoint to the intersection point at 4, and then from the intersection point at 4 to the right endpoint at 7. And from 1 to 4, remember that f of x is above g of x. It's greater than g of x. You can see here in our graph, f of x here is higher, it's above, it's greater than g of x. So we will go ahead and write our integral from 1 to 4, again, the left endpoint to the point of intersection. And because f of x is above g of x, we'll write f of x first, 12x minus 3x squared, and then subtract the lower function, which is g of x, 6x minus 24 dx. Then we need to add to that the area from 4 to 7, right? From the intersection point 4 to the right end point of our range, 7. And because g of x is above f of x, the graphs have crossed each other, and g of x is above f of x, we'll go ahead and write g of x first. So 6x minus 24, and then we'll subtract from that the lower function, so we'll get 12x minus 3x squared here, and then of course dx. So we've now set up our integrals to find the area, and all we have to do is evaluate these definite integrals. So the first thing we'll want to do is simplify the integrals as much as possible. So we'll get 12x minus 3x squared minus 6x plus 24 dx, and then plus the integral from 4 to 7 of 6x minus 24 minus 12x plus 3x squared dx. Okay, then we can simplify further the integral from 1 to 4. Let's order our terms from the highest degree to the lowest degree. We'll put negative 3x squared first since it's the highest degree term. 12x minus 6x is a positive 6x plus 24 dx. And then we add to that the integral from 4 to 7 of, again, 3x squared first. 6x minus 12x is a negative 6x minus 24 dx. All right, so now we can go ahead and integrate because we've simplified as much as possible. And remember that when we're integrating, we will add 1 to the exponent of each of these terms and then divide the coefficient on the term by the new exponent. So if we take 3x squared here, we'll add 1 to the exponent. So instead of x squared, we'll get x cubed. We added 1 to 2 to get 3. And then we will divide the coefficient, which is negative 3, by the new exponent, which is currently 3. So we divide negative 3 by 3, and of course we just get negative 1, so the coefficient is negative 1. So negative x cubed, this will be 6 divided by 2 will be 3x squared, and then plus 24x. And of course we're going to be evaluating that on the range 1 to 4. Then we add to that other integral, so we'll get x cubed minus 3x squared minus 24x, which we're evaluating on the range 4 to 7. All right, so now that we've done that, let's go ahead and give ourselves a little bit more room here. We will go ahead and plug in our limits of integration. So first, remember that when you're evaluating these definite integrals, you always plug in the top number first and then subtract and then plug in the bottom number. So we'll plug in 4 first. So we'll get negative 4 cubed plus 3 times 4 squared plus 24 times 4, right? And then we will subtract from that what we get when we plug in 1, which is the lower limit of integration. So negative 1 cubed plus 3 times 1 squared plus 24 times 1. And then we will add to that, right, what we get when we integrate from, or when we plug in the limits of integration from 4 to 7. So again, we'll plug in 7 first. So we'll get 7 cubed minus 3 times 7 squared minus 24 times 7. And then subtract from that what we get when we plug in 4. So we'll get 4 cubed minus 3 times 4 squared minus 24 times 4. So simple as that. We've now got our whole, it's just arithmetic at this point, everything's set up. So when we simplify this, you can see we'll get 4 cubed is 64, so we get a negative 64, 4 squared is 16, times 3 is 48, so we get a plus 48, and then 4 times 24 is 96, so we get a positive 96, and then we will subtract everything that we get here. So we'll get a negative 1 plus 3 plus 24. Then we'll add to that 7 cubed, which is 343. And then 7 squared is 49 times 3 is 147. So minus 147. And then 24 times 7 is 168. So we'll get minus 168, and then subtract from that 4 cubed, which again is 64. 4 squared is 16 times 3 is 48, so minus 48, and then a minus 96 for the 24 times 4. So when we simplify this all out, we'll get negative 64 plus 48 plus 96, and then we get plus 1 minus 3 minus 24 plus 343, and we're just distributing the negative signs here, minus 147 minus 168 minus 64 plus 48 plus 96. And if we do that, arithmetic on our calculator, we will get a final answer of area equals 162. And that's our final answer. That is the total area between the curves on the range 1 to 7. So visually, let's look at what that looks like. That's everything here, right, between these two curves from 1 to 4, and then between the two curves here from 4 to 7. It's this whole area right here. So that's the area between the curves on the range 1 to 7 when the graphs intersect at 4. I really hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.